I call it Jane's crazy mixed up salt. It's all kinds of seasonings and stuff, man.
Do that again.
What did you do that for?
I had a commercial play.
Oh, we gotta do this again? Take two. Is it on record now?
Yes, sorry.
All right then. Yeah, I gotta do the song again. What year was it? I know it wasn't that. Anyway, it don't make any difference. In my grade over here, I'm fixing add some crazy mixed up stuff. This is called Jane's Crazy Mixed Up Seasoning. Some great stuff right here. Did you get that time?
Yeah.
About to make a big ass biscuit over here. I don't know if I put enough in there. I have to do one of those taste tests. See it all cooking around the pan like that? It's starting to look like a crepe. I'm not here to make crepes tonight, or creeps, or whatever you call it. And this is my test finger. Birds out, don't buy that damn value shit from Walmart, because you'll get stems, and you might get some seeds. Those chicken fried steaks only take 5 minutes to cook. I'm not used to that. That's telling me that there's very little beef in it. Welcome to the J.O. Kitchen from Hell. And I am in a pissed off mood today. Because everything I touch turned to you know, onions cook down, so I'm cooking up a lot of onions. Now getting it on my damn nice white chef's jacket. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cut these up in little bitty portions. This looks like some real healthy liver here. And I was used to fat liver back in the day. A little shake and bake there one time. And this is ready to go. I didn't put any salt and pepper on it because I'm going to do all the seasoning in the gravy. Straight up fried just like this, no seasonings. Good brown just like that. It's got a nice little fine bread on it. Y'all can clean, whoever's doing this, you can clean that black it out. It's going to dissolve in the gravy and give it a nice flavor. Everybody should know how to make a roux. This is fry up the flour in this oil to get some little dough balls. What I'm doing is I'm doing a mixture of beef base and so I can put in this roux. Some balls that's going to turn into gravy in a little bit. That's not good. this is a thing that you do in a kitchen that you have to keep experimenting with. I mean, I feel like a damn scientist. Let's see. Whose DNA is this? It's a damn cow. In the old day, that's the way you would see your liver and onions with that. But I'm just going to put a touch of this in there. Just a touch. Or two. That's about all we need to give it that healthy look. Okay, now it's time to put the onions in. I'm going to add a little bit more water to thin this gravy out because it's kind of thick. And then I'm going to place the liver down in this and kind of, you know, put the gravy over the liver a little bit. And that's it. You serve it, you eat it. Cornbread, it's got about 3 more minutes and it comes out. Let's look in here and see what it looks like. See, it's not nowhere near done. And then I'm going to just do some Brussels in the microwave. So you've been listening to and been watching the JL Kitchen from Hell. This would have been a great show to do if I was in a pissed off mood. Everything's been a real lovely day. And that's your onions and gravy right there. I'm not going to put the liver in there yet. It's not going to go on the table until this is done perfecto. Next time I make it, I'm really going to beat this. This is something you just have to keep experimenting with until you get it right. And see, it's starting to do just the way you see liver and onions. It's just about that. That's just about it right there. Here's a big old piece right here. It might all fit. I forgot, meat shrinks too. Look at this mess I made. Thank you for watching this portion of the program from the JL Kitchen from Hell. The camera person is Leonard. And she can flip that camera around and take a shot of herself if she wants to. Do you want to do that? No, you do it with camera, Leonard. Did you not learn something from camera, Leonard?